Ready, set, go. Oh.
So this is Blair. He's a 21-year-old fella. Today he was on a dirt bike.
And he's just slipped forward. Yeah. He was right in the air and fallen really hard.
Got a lot of pain in his right femur.
Yeah, priority is probably going to be some analgesia, which we've got some fentanyl out. And could we get portable x-rays for a trauma around here? We'd be worried about head injuries and chest injuries. We suspect, obviously, your right leg is probably broken.
Oh, watch out for that femur, please.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Oh, oh.
Would you rescue me when I'm by myself? When I need your love, if I need your help, would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? But I start to wonder if I'm slipping under. Oh, would you rescue me? Would you give my
very worried for you, my friend.
The bone's being smashed to bits.
Whoa!
He's actually stopped breathing.
Yeah.
Without intervention, he's quite likely to die.
Better?
Emergency doctors Andrew Trezise and Jane Hamilton.
Do you know, I always wanted to be a children's TV programme presenter when I grew up.
Did you?
Yeah.
And now you're stuck doing medicine.
Are discussing dream jobs they wanted to do when they were kids.
Yeah, it was either the presenter or a doctor.
Or a doctor. I mean, I used to want to be a truck driver, so, you know.
Did you?
Yeah, when I was about six or whatever, I was like, I just want to drive a truck.
That was the age I wanted to do TV.
We clearly had divergent paths, but we ended up, you know.
Oh, dear.
Dr. Andrew's sticking with the day job as an air ambulance arrives from country Victoria.
Look at that. Thank you.
The patient is 21-year-old Blair, who crashed his dirt bike after failing to land a jump.
Just keep your head nice and still, mate.
Blair was celebrating one of his brother's birthdays when the accident happened.
Yeah, I got four brothers.
Yep, they were all there.
Blair's family saw him crash and are now rushing in to the Royal Melbourne.
They've landed. So I think, yeah, priority is probably going to be some analgesia, which we've got some fentanyl out.
They're bringing in a young chap. He's been up in the air and landed probably at, we assume, quite a high speed.
Yeah. Keep your head nice and still.
Sounds like he's either hit his head or injured his leg or probably both.
G'day, buddy. What's your name?
Blair.
I'm Andrew, one of the doctors here. How are you going?
I've been better.
Been better, yeah.
Yeah, no.
When I see Blair for the first time, he's talking to us and he's awake, which is one of the most important things we look for when a patient arrives. That tells me that their brain's working reasonably well.
Ready, set, go. Oh, and back. Ready, set, go. Oh, it's not broken, eh?
With Blair obviously in severe pain, the team immediately start assessing him for any internal injuries that could be life-threatening.
So this is Blair. He's a 21-year-old fella. Today he was on a dirt bike.
Yep.
Riding about 40 to 50k, he's gone across a jump, the front wheel has dropped, and he's gone over the handlebars, landing significantly on his helmet, and then the bike has flipped and landed on his chest and on his leg.
Okay.
Initially, he's a little bit confused with retrograde amnesia.
Yep.
Obvious right femur.
Oh, yes, a lot of pressure in there. My femur.
Apparently, he rolled a truck about a week ago.
Okay.
But no major injuries other than a head strike.
Yeah, okay.
So I don't know if that was even investigated heavily.
This is the second major accident Blair has had in the last 2 weeks.
No, I did roll a truck on Tuesday, last week.
Blair's had this pretty recent head injury already. Receiving a second head injury within a week or so is never good. It's always going to make us be a bit more concerned about the severity of injuries that he could have received. And certainly this second one sounds very significant.
Could we get portable x-rays for a trauma around here, if that's okay?
Pass is negative.
Fantastic.
Lungs are okay. He's got a lot of pain in his right femur.
Yes, there's no suggestion of any fluid in the abdomen. Blair's probably not got any significant bleeding into his belly.
Here we go.
So this was the actual accident.
Before the paramedics leave, they're able to show Dr. Andrew footage of the accident sent by Blair's family.
It's
So it's going quite quick. So you can see the bike's flipped over on top of him.
We don't often get to see footage of the injury that our patients have. You know, I was sort of imagining he's gone over this jump and kind of landed from the top of a ramp or whatever, but you know, he was right in the air and he's fallen really, really hard.
So you've sort of come off this jump, gone kind of forward and probably landed forward onto the helmet, is that right, do you think?
I don't know.
People tend to get memory loss with head injuries due to the fact that the brain takes a big impact and kind of almost essentially shuts itself down for a little bit.
Obviously, it's a pretty decent fall you've had. We'd be worried about head injuries and chest injuries. We suspect, obviously, your right leg is probably broken, okay? So we're gonna get an X-ray of that. And what we'll have to do is we'll scan basically everything from your head down to your pelvis, okay, through a CT scanner.
Blair's come off his bike and the only injury is a broken leg, I would be very surprised. We always look for more. Well, the mainstay of that really is a CT scan where we look at the brain, the chest, the abdomen. They're the most common sites for injury and also the most life-threatening injuries.
Before sending Blair for a CT scan, Dr. Andrew wants to make sure he doesn't have any obvious spinal injuries.
Also, I need to check around your anus for sensations, to check for spinal cord injuries.
Around or in it?
Around. Check the sensation and then you can squeeze your buttocks.
Okay. Yeah, he's in pretty good spirits, isn't he? Like, he's, he's obviously trying to see the funny side of it. I bet underneath he's probably pretty worried about what's happened.
Oh, that leg being hurt. Watch out for that femur, please.
Yeah. We're going to support it here. On your count.
Ready?
One, two, three.
Oh.
Emergency nurse Gunnar Pedersen is a world away from where he grew up in Iceland, but is now happily settled with his family in Melbourne.
Oh, this was a beautiful morning. Woke up early, dropped the kids off to school. I listened to some death metal on the way and get myself geared up for the shift and hope for the best, prepare for the worst.
As the ED's resus team leader...
I got more phone calls, this is endless.
It's Nurse Gunner's job to coordinate resources...
Resus 5, bring them out.
...in life and death situations.
Now we're getting two very sick people at the same time.
This is like orchestrating a very chaotic symphony.
But as a father of twins, he's an expert in juggling.
This thing does not stop yet.
Things get very busy very fast there. And my job is to ensure that it happens safely.
The ED receives word of a trauma patient about to arrive.
See you in 10, 15 minutes, Robert.
So we got a patient falling off a horse. I've seen quite a few nasty injuries from horses. Long face. So I'm not sure the ETA, probably about 10 minutes. So let's get started, get a team together.
With an injured horse rider on the way, emergency doctor Jonathan Papson is on standby.
When people are on a horse, not only do you fall from a height, but you fall at a speed. So it can be quite a nasty fall off a horse.
25-year-old Laura is in excruciating pain after falling from her horse and landing heavily while show jumping.
Are you a partner or...? Okay, we'll maybe get you to stand outside just while we get a hold of the situation.
Ready, set, go. There we go, well done.
Laura, so lots going to happen in a very short period of time, okay?
So she's a 25-year-old female with no medical history. 12:30 today, she's fallen off a horse. Her partner over here has a video of the incident.
Obviously, a pretty significant pain.
Hit her left side scapula and thoracic region on a treated pine post in the ground.
Nice.
Fell to the ground after that.
Oh, I'm going to bring that up.
Complaining of pretty significant pain in that left.
As opposed to rib fractures, this has got a scapular fracture, this has got a pneumo from that, anterior as well. So that's the business, isn't it?
To get a better idea of what happened, Dr. Jonathan talks with Laura's boyfriend, also Jonathan.
Hey, did you have a video?
I did.
Yeah. Can I have a look?
Yeah, so she's jumped, and she's kind of just come off and then straight to the side of it.
All right, okay. Yeah.
Laura's had Timmy, her new horse, for about 3 weeks, and this was her first clinic. Just super excited to go out there and see what he can do, because this horse can really jump and he's got some really powerful movements. And then she got in there and we'd done one, and she got through, and then she did the second one, and Timmy just pulled up a bit short, and she's come off, and Timmy's gone to the left, and she's gone towards the post right near the fence, and she's come around and wrapped around like a banana, and she's come off second best.
Laura, hi, my name's Jonathan, one of the specialists. How are you feeling?
Pain.
Been better. Is it pain sort of in your chest, on the side?
Chest, like between my breastbone and all the way.
So, in the front?
Yeah.
And
all the way through my back.
Yeah, all right. So
it really hurts to move my left arm.
Does it? All right. We're going to get something more for the pain and then we'll have a thorough look at you. So when we hear someone's fallen off a horse, what I'd be worried about is broken ribs. And when you break your ribs, you can hurt your lung and breathing is difficult, and that'll make your oxygen level low.
Good.
So what we might do is cut this off so we can have a proper look. Oh, there we go. Was that the pole or something you landed on? The ambulance said you might have fallen on a pole or something, or struck a beam or something, smashing the fence.
She's got a mark on her chest, so I'm worried that she may have broken the front of her ribs, but there's got to be more to it.
With your shoulder, can you move it, the shoulder?
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Oh,
21-year-old Blair is being examined for spinal injuries after he crashed his dirt bike and landed heavily.
No. Sore to touch? Yes, no.
No.
Dr. Andrew wants to make sure he's stable enough to move to CT so they can scan for any brain injuries.
There's a bruise and a raise. That's sore?
Either way, we're
touching you there?
No, my femur hurts.
I'm just gonna put a sticker on there, actually.
I get a sticker. I'm a service sausage. Ah, my femur.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3.
Oh, I feel it moving. That's hectic, yeah.
Oh, pull your head down.
Pull your head down. It's possible that, like, if there's a break in your neck as well, that you won't be really feeling it. Feel your pain and spokes there, okay?
Oh.
So until we do the scan, make sure your neck's safe. You want to just try to lay still.
Emergency nurse Lachlan Peterson knows the importance of connecting with patients, especially younger ones.
Are you getting your Tinder profile up here?
I do, actually. Better give me phone over here. Oh, the birdies will be out.
More than happy to take a few private shots to yourself.
Oh, stop it.
When you've got the bravado up, these young people downplay things that could be key symptoms.
Which is that sign?
Obviously behind, because I've got a mullet.
When you can build that rapport with them, they're much more likely to talk to you about what's going on.
Yeah, some mad painkillers.
Is it tense?
It's very tense. It's probably deformed,
Still got good pulses.
It feels very tense.
It's going down the leg and it feels quite firm. The thing we think about is compartment syndrome, and that can suggest that there's potential that the blood supply is starting to get cut off down the leg, which is not good. Did you see as well? Sorry, just for a shoot through femur if we can.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you. Thanks, sir.
Dr. Andrew also wants to rule out any other major injuries.
Try and take a deep breath in there for me. Hold your breath. And relax.
Did you see the chest?
Chest looks fine.
Chest looks fine.
Oh,
okay. Yeah, it's okay.
The pelvis x-ray looks clear.
Yeah, it definitely feels tense though, not like.
It feels very tense, yeah.
Well, we'll see what this femur film looks like, and I'll give also a ring. Yeah, it's pretty badly broken.
Faces?
Yeah.
It looks ugly and needs some operation.
If you fracture the bone, you get some bleeding, and that bleeding can start to become contained by muscles within your leg. If the blood supply is cut off for long enough, the limb won't survive, and actually can cause injuries bad enough that mean that legs basically need to be amputated. That's a very complex fracture.
Lots of little bone fragments that can cause trouble.
Yep.
Good job. Out.
Sorry, doll. Just giving you some pain relief, okay?
25-year-old show jumper Laura is in acute pain after falling from her horse and smashing chest first into a wooden post.
Are you sore in the middle? You are. So your sternum is sore. And you're sore here?
Yeah.
Does it hurt there?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And what about right
now? Oh, that's going to be really sore.
Here, is that sore?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dr. Jonathan's first priority is to get her pain under control.
Why don't maybe just get 10 of morphine and might as well get some Maxilon as well. We'll give us some oral stuff too. What do you reckon?
People often have spinal injuries when they fall off a horse, a fractured neck, a fractured back, and truncal injuries, ribs and in your abdomen.
The ambulance were pretty comfortable that her pelvis was okay. It's hard to tell. You know, she's got a broken scapula, she could have a broken thoracic spine. We just need to be gentle and not too rough as we move her around. So just remember, the whole left side of the body, all very sore. So we'll just go very gently as you roll her.
OK, so stay nice and still there for us, Laura. One, two, three. Ah! Laura, pain here in your back? Yes or no?
Good.
Here? 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 Here in the middle? Here in the middle?
Yeah.
You all right? Where is it sore? Everywhere? OK. We're going to get you some more pain relief, OK?
Ah! Shoulder!
Excellent work. Okay.
Going back on one, two, three. Going to give you some more pain relief now, okay?
We've given her painkillers. We've got the pain still there. So she must have something broken there that we're just not seeing.
Sorry, my darling.
This kind of injury can be devastating and can stop someone from being able to do what they love, which is riding a horse.
Laura's mum, Paula, always feared this day would come.
Laura has had an obsession with horses ever since she was little. We were hoping she would grow out of it. Unfortunately, she didn't, and it just kept getting stronger and stronger and stronger. Being a dangerous sport, it's a type of call you know you are going to get one day. You hope you don't. But I think in the back of your mind, you know it is going to happen one day. Still not good when it does happen.
X-ray.
So, pelvis is closed. No obvious lumbar spine fractures. Hips look all right. It's very reassuring.
Laura's x-rays are clear, but Dr. Jonathan's not convinced.
What I'm worried about is that she's got rib fractures that I can't see on the plain x-ray. So I wouldn't be surprised when we go and do the CT that we'll see quite a lot of them.
Oh, I like your tattoo there. Cross his heart, eh?
So when you get an impact to your upper body, that compressive force can injure the structures underneath, which is really the lungs.
You okay there, Laura?
It really hurts when she breathes, and that's a problem because she needs to take big breaths to inflate her lungs so her oxygen level remains the way it should be.
If it hurts, you don't want to breathe, right? If you don't want to breathe, your lungs don't work, you're in trouble.
Dr. Jonathan wants to get to the bottom of Laura's pain as quickly as possible.
Is she far off or...?
Imminent.
Imminent. That's what we like to hear. All right. Here's the scan. So sometimes coming around and talking to the CT people at least makes me feel happy that she's going to get a scan sooner. Going to CT?
Yeah.
She's a priority. The sooner the better. Let's do it.
...21-year-old scrap metal worker Blair has a badly broken femur after crashing the dirt bike he was riding.
No, when you feel it round, it's
tense around the back as well, yeah.
Dr. Andrew is worried the firmness in Blair's leg could indicate a life-altering condition.
The worst thing, really, with this kind of injury is potential for compartment syndrome, and if that's really bad, people can lose their leg from that kind of injury.
Dr. Andrew breaks the terrible news to Blair.
All right, buddy, so x-ray we've just looked at. Definitely broken that leg, OK.
First broken bone.
Andy, I'm so sorry to interrupt.
That's okay.
You're going to have to move, step down for a moment.
Yep.
Because we've got a really sick patient. We need to move up.
No problem.
A critically ill patient has been rushed into emergency and needs the trauma bay. Blair is moved to a treatment room.
Sorry for the quick move. Yeah, so as I was saying, it's definitely broken. It's actually broken in a couple of places. Okay.
Good job.
Doing a great job.
Go hard or go home.
But it's definitely going to need an operation to fix it, okay? Because it's broken in a couple of places. One of the fragments is a bit loose and just hanging around in the leg.
I see.
All right.
He's going to need an operation to fix this fracture, definitely. It's going to be very painful for him.
The other thing that can happen is with a big fracture like this, you can actually get so much swelling in the leg here that it starts to compress those blood vessels. Mm-hmm. That's what's called compartment syndrome. Mm-hmm. Now, if that happens, we're going to have to urgently try and reduce that swelling, and sometimes that means urgent surgery. But we're going to be keeping a really close eye on it.
Fractures like this, they need to be fixed sooner rather than later because there's a lot of blood vessels that go through the leg, and there's always a potential that the fractured parts of the bone can shift and move and can actually cause damage to the blood vessels running down the leg.
Dad always told me go hard or go home. Guess we're not going home.
Where is Cheeky? He has a big heart, his head screwed on properly, he's funny. You always get 100% Blair. Blair is a daredevil. Has no fear. And I always say to Blair when he's going to go riding, be careful.
My foot's a bit numb.
Yeah? Tell me if it changes, particularly if it feels like it's getting cold. If the pain shoots up, let one of us know, OK? See, we're going to get the rest of the scans done soon. For now, I've got to keep you flat on your back. I can't let you have anything to drink.
I think it's definitely now hit home for Blair. He's a lot more worried about what's happened and started to realise things are a bit more serious. He's starting to think, am I going to be able to walk again?
Theatre, potentially tonight. Okay.
Sorry?
It might be going to operation tonight.
My foot's a bit numb.
Yeah. If the pain shoots up, let one of us know, okay?
Dirt bike rider Blair is being monitored for compartment syndrome in his right leg after breaking his femur in an accident.
It might be going to operation tonight.
If left untreated, compartment syndrome could result in Blair losing his leg.
You okay, Blair? You okay, buddy? What's up, man?
Oh, I've got a lot of pressure in my leg.
Is it really sore?
Oh, yeah.
Is that sore?
Where your thumb was?
Here?
No, back.
Back here somewhere. Okay.
Breaking your thigh bones is going to cause you a lot of discomfort. The trouble is we also need to monitor how his leg is feeling to him, because if it starts to get more and more and more painful to this point where it's sort of out of control pain, that he's starting to develop compartment syndrome.
I think you've probably...
A lot of pain.
You've definitely bruised some of the nerves in your leg, OK?
A lot of pain. Excruciating. It's like I'm having a truck run on me leg.
I'm going to give you some pain relief, OK? And we'll keep a close eye on you, and I'm waiting for the surgeons to come down and see you. OK.
This is a really tough balance. I want to be able to give him as much pain relief as I can, but actually, we kind of need to be conscious that if we give him too much pain relief, we might actually start to mask some of this escalation in pain.
That's right. Now my foot's going numb. I can feel it right down to my big toe.
With Blair in agony, he's taken immediately for a CT scan.
Just starting now. You're doing really well. We'll be finished in less than 2 minutes.
So Blair's come back from CT now. He's got a fractured leg.
So when we're looking through the scans, what we can see is that there is blood flowing through those vessels, and actually that it's flowing all the way down to his feet and supplying the whole leg. We're happy this compartment syndrome doesn't seem to be developing.
So there's no obvious big brain injury and there's no obvious neck injuries. And then we just scan down towards the pelvis here. And there you go. So there is a fracture on the left-hand side of the pelvis, which is a little bit unusual because the fractured leg is on the right-hand side. Sort of speaks to how big this injury is that Blair's had.
So it's what we call the acetabulum, which is the ball and socket joint of the hip. That can be fractured in high-impact accidents. The reason it's concerning is because that can mean that the hip joint then is unstable.
He's probably going to need an operation on both of those fractures and then a long period of physio rehab after that. All right, Blair, how are we going? In terms of the leg, the orthopedic doctors are going to come down shortly and they're going to have a chat to you about what we do from here. As I say, I'm pretty guaranteed it's going to need an operation. All right, but we'll get you fixed up. We'll get you back on the dirt bike eventually. It's going to be a bit of a long road, I think.
but we'll get you sorted, okay?
Yeah, well.
You'll get there. All right, bud.
Keep on cracking.
Yeah, okay. Chin up, eh? You'll be okay.
Yeah, well.
Good on you. All right, mate. See you later.
I'm sore. Cheers.
Emergency doctor Michael Dunn and his partner moved from Ireland to Melbourne 7 years ago after seeing rave reviews of the city online.
I love living and working in Melbourne. The culture and sport and food, and had two little kids and started a little family here. Yeah, it's been the right move for us.
Dr. Michael's been on the front line here for 6 years.
What I love about the job is that no day is the same. It's such a strong team that we have here that you feel part of something big when you come to work. I mean, I feel you come in and you're making a difference.
Dr. Michael's next case is being rushed into ED.
Royal Melbourne receiving.
We're just giving you a heads up. We're coming in with a male who's fallen around 3 metres to the ground. Don't believe there's been a head strike.
The patient is 57-year-old Craig, who's fallen off a roof.
You all right?
Paramedics have given him the green whistle for pain relief.
We have a gentleman in his 50s who's fallen from over 3 metres. And we've seen people who've had life-threatening injuries from falls of smaller heights than that.
Trauma one?
Okay.
Yeah.
Emergency nurse Ebony Butterworth needs to quickly find out what Craig's injuries could be.
Brief story. What's the brief one?
Fall from around 3 metres height. Onto ground, obvious fracture.
Humeral fracture, okay.
Father of three, Craig, has been a roofer for 37 years. He's had falls before, but this is the first time he's been seriously hurt.
Hello there. What's your pain score out of 10 right now?
4.
Okay, cool.
I don't quite believe what he's saying. You can see the break in his arm, and I feel like he could be one of those sorts of people that doesn't want to be a bother or make out as if it's something to worry about, but I'm worried about it.
Have you broken a bone before?
Never.
Never?
When he fell, the right side of Craig's body took the full force of the impact, leaving his arm broken near the shoulder.
No. Hi, Craig.
Hi.
I'm Michael, I'm a doctor. It's nice to meet you. What happened today?
So I was working on the roof. I went to stand on the ladder and stood where I should not and hit the ground.
Did the ladder slide or did you come off the ladder?
No, I sort of tried to grab the ladder and tried to stop my fall and ended up all twisted.
And you think you fell 3 metres?
Correct.
And family-wise, who's at home?
My wife's on her way. She's at work in Geelong, so
yeah.
She's having a cup of coffee to calm her nerve.
Very sensible.
Craig's son, Alex, is on his way to be with him, while his other son, Tim, waits at home.
And anyone else at home?
We've got a 31-year-old son with an intellectual disability that lives with us as well.
OK.
And he's got a carer there with him. He's priority.
Good, OK.
That he has a son who he cares for brings to light where his mind may be. If he can't use that arm, he can't work. I suspect Craig is pretty worried and pretty scared.
Because you fall in such a high distance, we're going to have to make sure you haven't injured anywhere else. Because of that sudden impact, sure. Some of the organs get shaken around to make sure they're OK.
Yeah.
We'll take you for a scan.
No worries.
It's crucial that Dr. Michael finds out if Craig has any potentially life-threatening injuries.
Were you walking around after it happens?
I stood up, yeah, but then I started to feel dizzy, so
I can imagine.
I better lie down, I think, before I fall down.
Yeah. Alarm bells go off. Craig may have hit his head when he fell, he doesn't remember, and he could have some degree of brain injury that could be a life threat.
Well, she's fallen off a horse, so I'm anxious to see what a scan looks like.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
25-year-old show jumper Laura is about to be scanned for injuries after being thrown from her horse, Timmy, during a training day.
Initial x-rays look fine, but we're nowhere out of the woods because you only see a third of rib fractures normally anyway on the plain x-ray. All right, mate, you reckon? We can go in? Yeah.
Dr. Jonathan fears the passionate rider may have spinal injuries.
No, oh, sorry. Grab that. I won't grab the shoulder. How about I just grab that bit? Is that all right?
All right, just deep breaths, OK? All right, on three, one, two, three.
Well done. So just that left shoulder scapular area is really sore.
One, two, three. There you go.
Well
You're
done.
You're on CT bed now, OK?
Is it broken?
It's really sad when someone's doing something they love and then you see them have an accident and it's kind of all turned on its head.
It might be broken. Could be, yeah.
A nasty horse fall injury could be the end of someone's career riding a horse. So let's just hope that her spine's okay on that CT.
They'll reformat the images. I think we've got lots of rib fractures. No surprise. But we'll wait for the reformats and then we'll have another look.
Laura is taken back to the trauma bay, where she'll wait to find out if her riding days are over.
Laura and horses, that's her everything. Every spare minute, if she's with a horse, whether she's cleaning them or feeding them or riding them or brushing them or just looking after them, her whole life revolves around horses. If she couldn't ride, she would have a pretty miserable life. She wouldn't know who she was.
Finally, Dr. Jonathan can clearly see Laura's injuries.
It's amazing compared to the plain x-ray. I'm seeing a lot of broken ribs and they're actually displaced and out of place all the way down the left side of her chest. So no wonder she's in so much pain. Let's see if we can have a look at the sternum, so the breastbone. Yeah, there's a little break in that too. So she's got a fracture in the sternum, which is why she's so sore all the way around. She's got the big red mark here. That makes a whole lot of sense.
The ribs will take 6 weeks to heal, but her pain's probably going to be worse for a couple of days. All this looks pretty bad, but look, Laura's a fit young person. How long do I think it'll be until she's back on the horse? Let's hope it's not too soon, because we've got to get those ribs healed. But she'll be back on that horse.
Four-year-old roofer Craig is having a CT scan.
We're not going to do a full roll, obviously, because his arm is very sore.
Dr. Michael is looking for internal injuries after Craig fell 3 metres off a roof, badly breaking his arm.
1, 2, 3. There we go. Good job.
At a fall at that height, Craig could have had some bleeding in the brain, spinal injuries, injuries to the lung, heart, the liver. Those sort of things can be pretty catastrophic.
Brain scan looks good, so let's wait for the rest of the scan.
And ready, steady, strike. Great.
Craig's son, Alex, is here to see his dad.
Hey, Dad.
G'day, how you going?
Everything
all right? Yeah, look. Yesterday we talked about, so I've never broken a bone, so
back too soon.
Craig's scan shows he doesn't have neck or spinal injuries.
Hello.
Yeah, mate, how you going?
Keep us off.
Thank you. I knew that was all right.
How's the head?
Yeah, fine.
Yeah? Chin to chest? Good. Good. Okay, good.
Dr. Michael needs to find out if Craig's broken arm will need surgery.
Hello.
Hello. How are you?
Should we need to go for an x-ray?
Okay. I have a $100 bet that my arm's broken.
I would bet the same thing, actually. Yeah.
While waiting for x-rays, Nurse Ebony has seen something alarming.
Definitely looks more swollen than before.
Just like numb pain.
Okay. His arm suddenly looks even more swollen, so that is a major worry. He's at risk of compartment syndrome, which is extremely serious. Don't be too tough, all right? You need to let me know when you've got pain, like
that
then.
Hurts.
Yes, okay, see? Yeah.
The x-ray shows the break in Craig's arm is severe.
This is his humerus right here. He's got a mid-shaft fracture, so that should be one straight line, and it's definitely not a line.
Ruth Tyler and father of three Craig is back from x-ray.
The Minister of Finance, mate, you're in big trouble.
Oh, here we go. It's lecture time.
Waiting for him is his wife, Denise, and son, Alex.
What are you doing?
Seeing if you bounce.
Trying to get attention.
One way to get on the TV.
This is very swollen here. Are you sure your pain hasn't increased at all?
Yeah, no, I'm fine.
It's OK?
Yeah.
You're not just saying that because your wife just walked in? And...
No.
I'm going to go have a chat to Michael. He can just have a quick look at the x-rays.
Yep.
Okay, cool.
The swelling with Craig's arm is due to the fact that the fracture is not aligned, but also he has some secondary swelling from the actual brick itself. And I'm not concerned at this point in time that he is going to develop compartment syndrome. So he's been somewhat fortunate to come through this without any significant complications.
Hello. We can sit you up. Scans are okay. Just the broken arm, which you know about. The rest of the scans are fine. We're going to get you into a sling, but all scans look very reassuring.
Craig's arm will now be put into a cast.
It's a simple process, and the whole idea is that gravity helps fracture realign.
A lot of the builders are chasing plasterers. I'll give them your number.
We can't do straight walls. That's our only problem.
For someone like Craig, where his work and his livelihood depends on, this broken arm can be pretty substantial. We don't know what degree of rehab he's going to need so he can do his job safely. So this is going to have a major impact on his life.
With Craig needing to spend a couple of days in hospital, wife Denise is worried what she'll do without her superstar chef.
He likes to buy fresh food every day, so beautiful. So we really hope that his arm heals up.
Just so I can do the cooking.
It's so cheeky.
Emergency nurse practitioner Paul Casey's next patient's waiting.
Hi, I'm Paul. I'm one of the nurse practitioners. And your name is?
My name's Susan.
55-year-old biology teacher Susan is worried because the painful sore behind her left knee is growing bigger by the day.
I'm here today because now it's an open wound. It just looked like an infected mozzie bite, quite small when it first presented. So we've had antibiotics and they didn't do anything. I'm feeling nervous because it's a flesh-eating ulcer that's taken off.
Susan's come into ED because a GP has found that she's got a Borrelia ulcer. It's a ulcer of the skin that originates from a bacteria.
You've had normal sensation and a rest of your leg.
Yes, and it had no pain. Yeah. But now that the surface of the skin is broken, that's where the pain is.
The pain's coming in now.
In Australia, it's linked to possums or mosquitoes, but no one knows exactly how it gets into humans.
Right, I'm going to go and set that trolley up. When I've done that, we'll have a look.
OK, all
right.
Thank you. We bought a Renovator's Delight down at Rosebud last year, and the problem is that the front of the house was covered in ivy. So I've spent last summer pulling out ivy. Within that ivy, apparently, I must have picked up a bacterial infection. Now it has no ivy, but I have an ulcer.
I'll just get everything ready so that it doesn't become a crime scene. So is it blood that's coming out or pus?
Fluid. Clear fluid mixed with some blood.
Yeah. Turn yourself over.
Nurse Paul gets his first look at the wound and can see why the mum of two is so concerned.
I see quite a large swelling to the back of the left knee. It's quite red and quite inflamed. It's obviously been there for a period of time.
You turned it down here?
No.
Up here? It's,
yeah, around.
It looks like it's spreading, doesn't it?
Yeah.
There's probably a bit of pus in there. I'm just going to give it a bit of a clean. All right, I'm just going to take a picture of it.
Nurse Paul photographs the wound, so he'll be able to enlarge the image to look at it in more detail.
Once the bacteria gets into the skin, it releases toxins, which then eat away at the skin tissue and then causes ulcers. And the danger with that is you can end up with, like, a permanent disability because of it.
I'll speak to the infectious disease doctors and see if we need to give you any intravenous antibiotics.
OK.
And whether they need to do anything more definitive.
Yes.
Biology teacher Susan came into ED with an ulcer growing on the back of her knee. Nurse Paul's having a close look at the photos he's just taken and can see how fast the infection is spreading.
So the surrounding skin's becoming more red up here and she's tender around here, which suggests the infection may be tracking up her leg. It's the first time that I've come across a Borrelia ulcer in person. I've heard about them, but I've not actually seen one.
So this has got an open wound here, which looks like it's had some pus come out of it. This is quite hard here, as suggested that there might be a collection there. So she needs an ultrasound to confirm that.
Nurse Paul calls on the experience of Dr. Jeremy Clark.
Hey, mate, how are you?
From the Infectious Diseases Department. Dr. Jeremy does an ultrasound to check for infection deep under the wound.
Yeah, no fluid.
And the news is good.
Just very, very angry fat and soft tissue. No, that's okay. Everyone's got fat under the skin. So Bruelli ulcer, but makes the skin very, very angry. And this is in a very awkward spot because if there's pus under there, it needs to be drained out.
Okay.
To set the scene of treating Bruelli ulcer, it's a long journey ahead. And the first bit will be unsatisfying because it does it doesn't get better quickly.
Okay.
In fact, it usually gets a little bit worse at the start. Okay. At the end of 8 weeks of therapy, the ulcer doesn't look that good.
Yep.
Just all the bugs are dead.
Yep.
And then the healing finishes off after that.
Okay.
Dr. Jeremy thinks that there's also a staph infection in the wound, and he's recommended an 8-week course of antibiotics.
You can turn over now if you want.
Ulcers are difficult to treat and they can take a long time before they heal properly. So if Susan's in this situation 7 or 8 months down the line, they may even consider a skin graft, but hopefully the wound will heal up in time.
Bit of relief going on now, and I can start treatment today. My leg isn't going to be eaten away, so I'm very happy. So that's a relief.
...21-year-old Blair was choppered in from country Victoria...
Just keep your head nice still, mate.
...after crashing his dirt bike on a high-speed jump.
Oh, I thought we were broken, eh?
Blair suffered a severely broken femur and a broken pelvis.
It's definitely going to need an operation to fix it, OK?
Three months on, after surgery and rehab, Blair still has a way to go, but is pushing through in typical larrikin style.
I've got some nice scars, battle wounds. Looks like a shark bite. And then I pull my pants off and show them my scars. They love it. I had my right femur surgery and my left pelvis. I know I've got a big nail through my leg, through my femur, two screws and a piece of wire holding a butterfly fracture off. And then I've had my pelvis surgery as well. In my x-rays, looks like I had a pocket full of screws.
With love and support from his family and mum Rachel, he's putting his life back together.
I like how you're positive. You're a good boy.
Cheers, mum.
Super proud of you. Hey, my precious little man.
Thanks, mum.
That's all right, yeah.
But it's only a matter of time until Blair's back on two wheels.
My only regret is not hitting the jump fast enough and not making it. As far as jumping on a motorbike, I will go back to doing that because it's just fun. I enjoy doing it.
After clearing ivy in her garden on the Mornington Peninsula, biology teacher Susan came into ED with a rare flesh-eating Bruelli ulcer that was getting bigger. Nurse practitioner Paul called on the experience of Dr. Jeremy from the Infectious Diseases Department. After having the wound dressed, Susan went home with a course of antibiotics and a warning it may be many weeks until the ulcer would heal. It took 2 months, two operations, a skin graft and a week in hospital to finally rid her leg of the ulcer. And now, Susan is back at work. 54-year-old Craig fell 3 metres off a roof, badly breaking his right arm.
This is his humerus. He's got a mid-shaft fracture.
It was a serious setback for the hard-working father of three, who's been a roof tiler all his life.
If he can't use that arm, he can't work. I suspect Craig is pretty worried and pretty scared.
After surgery to put a plate in his arm and a night in hospital, Craig went home to recuperate.
I can't wait to get all the weeds out now that my arm's getting better.
Yeah, we'll get there. Just do a little bit at a time.
Despite his wife Denise's concerns about him working on high roofs, he has no intention of quitting the business.
I certainly get my fair share of lectures off Denise about it, saying I shouldn't be doing it. Got to pay the bills. I'm a creature of habit. It took me a long time to get half decent at it, so I like to stick to what I'm good at.
Since the accident, though, Craig is being more careful of what he says.
The day before, I was in the office bragging that I'd never broken a bone and hope I never do. So I learnt my lesson from that one. Won't say that ever again. The hospital staff, the doctors, the emergency team in the trauma section, they were brilliant.
Ready, set, go.
25-year-old Laura came into emergency in excruciating pain. After falling from her horse while show jumping.
Was that the pole or something you landed on?
A CT scan revealed the cause of her pain.
I'm seeing a lot of broken ribs.
It's been 5 months since the accident, and Laura's life is finally getting back to normal after a tough recovery.
I broke my back, I broke my sternum, I completely shattered 5 ribs. I now have 5 plates with 27 screws holding 5 ribs together down my left, and shattering all those ribs also collapsed my left lung.
She will never forget the moment she fell.
I remember hitting the post and my body just collapsed underneath me. I couldn't hold myself up. So it was quite scary.
Laura's had some challenges with her recovery.
The first probably week in hospital was really tough. I didn't see myself ever being able to get back on a horse again. It was just that huge sort of mental barrier. My family were actually the ones pushing me to get back on the horse. Like, you won't forgive yourself if you just give up on everything and don't get back on.
And now, Laura and Timmy are back doing what they love.
Our first show jumping competition is booked for the end of September. So I'm really, really working hard to get to that competition. The treatment at the Royal Melbourne was just absolutely phenomenal. Very understanding and lovely and reassuring me about everything. My life's going really, really great now.